Hello, welcome to your new session. Today we are going to discuss about snapshot testing. Snapshot testing is basically a type of visual testing where we are going to compare two images like snapshots, like the previous image and the recent image. So we are going to use Sikuli here. So please add these dependencies in your pom.xml. Take this version only, don't take the latest version. If you take the latest version, you need to add OpenCV 4. Something the version. In some of the machines it is not there and you need to install Pythons and all. In my machine it's not there, that's the reason I have not taken that. So how does snapshot testing work with Java and also? I have used here Java, Cucumber, Selenium. The reason when using all this is like this is the latest trend which is going in Cucumber and all. In next video I will explain how to do it with the test ng also. It's very easy. So what I had done it, I have taken two scenario. One is before a deployment and another is after deployment. So before deployment, what we will do, we will just take the screenshot of all the pages. So in this scenario which I have written here, user navigate to women page and take the screenshot, and user navigate to the t-shirt page and take the screenshot. Here just simple, we are using Selenium methods to take the screenshot and save into a folder. Okay, then we are going to execute the after deployment. So after deployment, you can tag it as a after deployment and you can run the script. After deployment, we are just navigating the same page and then we are validating with the old images. If the current image and the old image is matching or not after the deployment. Similar to that, user navigate to t-shirt page and validate t-shirt page. If the old image and the current image is matching or not after the deployment. Okay. So what we need to do, you see, I have created two steps are there for the one scenario. It's like before. So in before, just simply taking the screenshot and saving into the snapshot. So I have written a method where I'm just saving it with the name as woman page. I went to the application, I click on a woman click, and then I took the screenshot. This is all are basically embedding into the HTML report, and this is for the extended report. I just added the extended report. So this is only doing the screenshot. So it's taking the screenshot and saving into in the form of PNG with the file name which I'm passing it. Okay, where it's saving, it is in the snapshot folder. Okay, so if you see here, I have taken the t-shirt image and then woman image and saved it. Okay, woman here. Okay, now after deployment. So after deployment, what we are doing it, we are executing these two steps. You can do as many steps as you have, but I'm just, for example, I have taken two steps. Okay, so user navigate to woman page. So I went to the application, and in place of going to the woman, I have just went to the t-shirt. The reason behind, I want to make the test case fail, whether the comparison is happening or not properly. I'm just want to test it. So I'm just checking whether the woman page is there or not. Since I have clicked on t-shirt, so woman page will be not there. So it will go into the else. So else it will say, woman page screenshot not matching. Okay, woman screenshot expected, and it is giving me the screenshot as a woman page. So what will happen, extend report will take the current screenshot and it will put in the report, and this is will put the woman page so we can compare it why it is failing. Correct. Similar to that, in the next step, user navigate to the t-shirt page and validate t-shirt page. Now here also we are going to the t-shirt page and compare with the t-shirt page. If it is pass, it will say t-shirt page matching, and it will take the current screenshot and it will make it pass. Okay, this is how we are doing it. Now recently I have run it and it has got pass or test cases. The after deployment execution will be pass because we don't want to make the fail. If we make fail, what will happen? I can use here in place of s.exit, I can use s.find. So what are the method we have used for the SQL? I'll just tell you. So just one simple method we have used for the SQL is like, we have created an object of screen. We have used the SQL and then we have used exit. If it exists, then we'll return a flag not null. If it does not exist, it will return a flag called null. So I'm comparing that both. Okay. Fine. So once compare, we can use also find also s.find, but s.find will hardcore fail the test cases if it is not matching. So I don't want to fail. I just want to capture which are the screenshot is failing for me right now. Okay, so I executed the test case from the runner class as I have given as after deployment, and it will execute it. Okay, now after execution, I went into the my test report in extended report, because I want to see the screenshot. So this is the best way of comparing the screenshot. So you see, woman page screenshot not matching. What is coming? It's a t-shirt is coming. Okay, fine, got it. Now what was expected? Expected was this woman page, but it is coming what? T-shirt page. So that's the reason it is failing. Similar to that, we can also execute that other script like before deployment, okay, and it will take the screenshot. So if I execute the before deployment, so what I have to do, I just have to give, and it will just go and take the screenshot and save it there. So this is how we can do a snapshot execution basically. So there are pages which are very static. If it is very dynamic, all the scripts will fail. So if you want to do some static page validations, whether the pages are coming properly or not, you can use this Sikuli snapshot testing. Even for the dynamic page also you can use it, but dynamic page will be like, if the images are keep on changing after deployments and all, then it is a difficult to validate whether the real executions have happened or not happened, or why it is failing is not, because if the texts are keep on changing, it will be like difficult to find out. Here in Sikuli is basically there is no difference are coming, like why it is failing. It's just failing that, okay, images are not present, and that's why it's failing. So we have run before deployment. So you see, before deployment, all the images it has taken and it has saved it. So this is showing as a pass. So this is how you can do the snapshot testing. Thank you for watching my videos. Please do subscribe.